what's up, English learners? It's your boy here, Teacher Lucas. Hope everything's doing fine with you today. Please follow me in all my social medias. Access my website there, teacherlucaspereira.com. If you don't know, I teach English every day on my Insta stories. Today I want to talk to you regarding the difference between may and can. I know that sometimes we get confused because, like, when you are learning English, generally you use can for everything. You forget about may, and sometimes you don't even know what may means. But there is a difference between one and the other. If you use one instead of the other, what you intend to say may not be understood by the other one that is listening, alright? So you need to understand what is the main difference between may and can, alright? So let's start with can. What does it mean, can? Most of you guys already know that can is used to express ability. For example, to swim. You can swim. I can't swim because I don't know yet, but I want to learn how to swim, but I don't know. So I can't swim, but you can swim, all right? You can drive a car. You can watch a television. It's an ability. You can understand English, alright? You can study English. It's the ability that you have. Can is an auxiliary verb, or also called as a modal verb, sometimes called as a helping verb as well. So even in America, kids, when they are in the school, they still don't know the difference between. Probably they would ask the teacher, "Can I go to the bathroom?" And to correct them, the teacher would probably answer them, "I don't know, can you?" And of course, he or she can go to the bathroom, alright? They don't have a disorder, a physical disorder, alright? So they can go to the bathroom. We need to understand that can is used to express ability. Whereas, when we are talking about may, may is also an auxiliary verb, but is used to express possibility or permission, alright? When we are talking about the example that I gave you before, the right question would be, may I go to the bathroom? Why? He's asking a permission if he's allowed to go to the bathroom, right? May I go to the bathroom? You could ask your mom, "Mom, may I go out tonight? May I go to the cinema?" And also a possibility. For example, it may rain tomorrow. There may be a storm tomorrow. I may attend the festival this weekend. You may borrow my jacket. If you finish your tasks, you may play outside. So may is used to express permission and possibility. Whereas can is used for ability. However, we can use can in an informal way. You can say, "Can I have a beer, please?" Whereas if you are in a company working, you have to say may, alright? "May I have a glass of water, please?" Because you need to be formal, alright? Whereas in a pub, you don't need to be formal. If you are in a very fancy restaurant, for example, you would ask the waiter or the waitress, "May I have a glass of wine, please?" Alright? Because it's very fancy, so you should be polite and formal. If you use can, they will understand. You can use can instead of may, but you cannot use may to replace can in case of possibility. Like, for example, "I can swim." You cannot say, "I may swim." They are grammatically right, but the meaning of each one is different. When you say, "I can swim," I understand that you have the ability to swim. But when you say, "I may swim," I understand that it's a possibility that you may swim one day. There is a difference between one and the other. So be careful when you use that. Hope you guys understand that. If you still have some questions or if it is still not clear for you, don't stay tuned. Leave your comments there. Also, please leave me some suggestions for next video if you want to learn something different. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Share with your friends. Hit the bell to receive notifications of new videos. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Peace out.